This is Marilyn Lohman, Service Hydrologist at WFO Pendleton. We'll be looking at the current snowpack conditions and the expected water supply for the coming spring and summer. This map is a measurement of the snow water equivalent or amount of water being held in the snowpack as of March 1, 2018 for the various basins across the state of Washington. From this map, produced by the Natural Resource Conservation Service, we can see that amounts were near 100% of normal in the upper and lower Yakima basins. The lower Snake Basin was showing 111% of normal, and within this basin, the Walla Walla Basin has increased quite a bit over the last month, from 60% to near 85% of normal. We'll look at some individual stations across the area. These charts show the snow water equivalent or water held in the snow for the water year October through September. The blue line is the maximum observed, with the red line the minimum, and green line is average. Using these charts, we can see how the winter snow water equivalent accumulates throughout the winter and spring and compared to average. The Touchet Snotel site is in the Walla Walla Basin around 5,500 feet. Looking at the black line, we can see that the snowpack decreased during the first part of February with the very mild temperatures we saw, and then increased through the second part of February, but continues to be below normal. The Sasse Ridge Snotel site is located in the upper Yakima Basin at 4,200 feet. Looking at the black line, we can see the snowpack had a steady increase through mid and late February and is near normal. The Bumping Ridge Snotel site is at 4,600 feet in the central Washington Cascades. Looking at the black line, the snowpack had steady accumulations from about mid to late February and is near normal. Looking at Oregon, even though this map shows below normal snowpack, there were some good increases in the snowpack during the past month. Looking at the snow water equivalent map from the NRCS as of March 1st, amounts increased from around 49% to 58% of normal in the Deschutes and Crooked basins, and from 45% to 59% of normal in the John Day Basin. In the Umatilla Basin, amounts increased from 70% to 77% of normal, and remain near 72% of normal for the Grande Ronde Basin. We'll look at some individual sites across the region. For the Northern Cascades of Oregon, the Red Hill Snotel is at elevation 4,400 feet. Looking at the black line, the current year observation, this site saw a small decrease at the beginning of the month as temperatures were very warm, and then a fairly steady increase through the rest of the month and is slightly below normal. In the Upper Deschutes Basin, the Three Creek Meadows Snotel site is at about 5,600 feet. Looking at the solid black line, we can see this location did see some accumulation during the last half of February, but is still well below normal and only slightly higher than the minimum observed for this time of year. For the John Day Basin, we can look at the Blue Mountain Springs site at 5,900 feet. There were some small increases during the last half of the month, but the snow amounts remain well below normal and are near the minimum observed for this location. For the Umatilla Basin in the Blue Mountains, we can look at the High Ridge site at 4,900 feet. The northern Blue Mountains are faring better than the rest of the state of Oregon. Looking at the black line, we can see that the snowpack has had a small decrease at the beginning of the month, and then increased during the second part of the month and is slightly below normal. In the Grande Ronde Basin, the Moss Springs Snotel site is at 5,800 feet. Looking at the black line, the snowpack increased steadily through the second half of February and is slightly below normal. The Northwest River Forecast Center uses Ensemble Streamflow Prediction, or ESP, generated forecasts as the official water supply method. The 30-year runoff normals covering the years 1981 to 2010 are being used. New ESP forecasts will be published on the Northwest River Forecast Center's website daily. For updated forecasts and more information on ESP forecasts, please see the River Forecast Center's website at the address given. This map from the Northwest River Forecast Center shows a snapshot of the water supply forecast for the coming season. As of March 1st, the water supply for the Pacific Northwest looks to be near normal over much of Washington, northern Idaho, and portions of northeast Oregon, with below normal water supplies for the rest of Oregon. We'll look at several stations within the area for a little more detail. For the Yakima River system, we'll look at the Yakima River near Parker. Looking at the plot, the solid green line is the 30-year normal. These plots show the entire range of forecast values, with the blue dot, the 50th percentile, our most likely value. We'll be using that most likely value and comparing it to normal. The volume forecast for the Yakima River near Parker for the period April through September is expected to be 115% of normal. The forecasted volume of the water, we're looking at the blue dot, for the Grande Ronde River near Troy, has increased to about 90% of normal. This value increased slightly from around 88% of normal seen back in January. These forecasts take into account the expected precipitation for the next 10 days and then normal precipitation throughout the rest of the period. For the Umatilla River at Pendleton for the period April through September, the volume forecast has increased to 98% of normal due to the increase in snowpack. Once again, these forecasts take into account the current 10-day forecast and then normal precipitation through the rest of the season. The Columbia River at the Dalles is an indicator for the entire Columbia Basin. Once again, we'll look at the average value plotted in green, with the most likely value the blue dot. The volume for the April through September period is slightly higher than last month at 112% of normal. The previous seen plots and additional water supply locations are available in an interactive form on the Northwest River Forecast Center's website at the address listed on the concluding slide. The three-month outlook from the Climate Prediction Center for March, April, and May shows increased chances of below normal temperatures across Washington and the northern half of Oregon, with equal chances of above, below, or normal precipitation over much of the Pacific Northwest. Here is the web address of the Northwest River Forecast Center where you can get additional and updated water supply forecasts. Join me again at the beginning of April as we continue to look at the snowpack and water supply conditions. If you have any questions, comments, or suggestions, please contact me by email or phone.